Dear student, today my lecture topic is Fundamental of Electromagnetism. These are the outline of my lecture. We will cover vector algebra, Gauss law, Ampere law, Faraday law, and Maxwell correction. In this slide, we will discuss just some basic fundamental of vector and its application in electromagnetism. When any object have a magnitude as well as a direction is known as vector. When any object have a only magnitude is known as a scalar. There are three types of the multiplication we are using in a vector algebra. When a vector is multiplied by any scalar quantity, the whole quantity is known as a vector. There are two types of multiplication when a vector is multiplied by another vector. This is known as a dot and cross product. The cross product is known as a vector, and the dot product is known as a scalar. Here we are defining a del oblique differential operator. Here this is a del function dy by dx, dy by dy, and dy by dz is taking in a x, y, z direction. This is whole quantity is known as a del operator. Similar, we are defining the multiplication like above situation. When the del operator is multiplied by any scalar function is known as a gradient. In a short form is a grid. It is also a vector like that. Here there are also two types of the multiplication when a delta is multiplied by any vector function. It's known as a dot, otherwise known as a cross product. The cross product is also known as a vector quantity. It is called by a curl. And other one is known as a dot product. Is also a scalar quantity like that above case. It is known as a divergence. In a short form is known as a dive. The physical meaning of these three parameter, the gradient means the direction in which any function change most repeatedly. We are measuring the of any scalar function. When we take the gradient, it is measure the direction in which any function change most repeatedly. But in the case of the divergence, it is measure the density of flux. And in case of the curl, it will measure the spinning flux. Here I am representing the mathematical form of above three product. In this slide, if gradient of any scalar function is zero, that function is constant everywhere. For example, in a room have a constant temperature because temperature have a scalar function. When a divergence of any vector is zero, it means number of the input and output field is the same. What is the meaning of that? Here I am taking a magnet. The magnetic field is varies outside of the magnet from north to south and inside going to south to north. When we measure the magnetic flux density, we will draw a cross section area. Here you can see the magnetic field cross this surface area from here to here, here to here. But the magnetic field is also cross this surface from here to here. both will be equal to this one. So del dot B is always zero in a electromagnetic theory. But in the case of electric field, here I am taking the two example. Here it is a negative charge, here a positive charge. Here the electric field is going inside, here electric field going outside. You can say that the direction is fixed but magnitude is varies. You can say here is large arrow, small arrow, then small arrow. It means that the del dot E equal to negative and del dot E equal to positive. It is behave as a sink, it is behave as a source. But curl of any vector is zero. It means that field is a irrotational. What is the meaning of the irrotational? If any field have a change in a magnitude as well as the direction, it is known as a rotating field. So that curl of B is equal to zero, it means that field is not rotated. Here I am using some basic formula, gradient of any scalar function, then curl is zero always, and curl of any vector, then divergence is zero, and curl of any vector and again curl, we can write like that. And here is also a important formula. This formula we will use frequently in the calculation of electromagnetic theory. Here I am using two important formula, divergence theorem and Stokes theorem. In case of the divergence theorem, basically we will convert the surface integration into volume integration, and Stokes theorem we will convert the surface integration into the line integration. In this slide we will discuss the Gauss law and Ampere law. The Gauss law: the total electric flux linked with a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by a closed surface. Here the charge is closed by a enclosed surface. The surface integration of electric field is equal to the q by y epsilon 0. It is known as integral form of the Gauss law. With the help of these two relation and divergence theorem, we can convert the integral form into the differential form. Del dot E is equal to rho y by epsilon naught. And Ampere law: the line integration around a closed path, this is a closed path, of a component of the magnetic field tangent to the direction of path. Here the magnetic field is always tangent to this closed path, equal to mu naught times the current intercept by the area. Here this current is always intercept this closed path. So it means that the line integration of the magnetic field is equal to mu naught into current. It is the integral form of the Ampere law. We can convert with the help of this relation in Stokes theorem into the differential form. Del cross B is equal to mu naught J. In this slide we will discuss the Faraday law. This law states that the rate of change of magnetic flux, this one, in a closed circuit induce a EMF which is opposed the cause d phi by dt. The phi V is equal to magnetic flux. We can also write the EMF in the form of line integration of electric field. Both we can equal both relation. We can say that is the integral form of the Faraday law. With the help of this relation and Stokes theorem, we can convert the integral form into the differential form. Del cross E is equal to d B by dt. What about the del dot B? As a magnetic line of the force, our closed curve is zero. It means that monopole does not exist. It means that we cannot separate north and south in a magnet. It means that total magnetic flux linked with a closed surface is always zero. Here you can see here the magnetic field is here and here will be equal to the this field. In and out is always equal. It means that it is the integral form. We can convert into differential form. The magnetic flux is always zero and del dot B is zero. You know the earlier slide. In this slide, we have summarized all the law in a single platform. Here I am showing the integral and differential form, electrostatics and magnetic field. This is the Gauss law, Faraday law, no name and Ampere law. When an integral form, Q is represent a charge, in a differential form, rho is a charge density. Similar for here, I is represent a current, in a differential form, it is J, is known as a current density. What is the Maxwell correction? The Maxwell is recognized some fault in Ampere law. Without this correction, we cannot develop the theory of the light. First, we recognize what is the fault, then we will give the solution in the next slide. Maxwell detect a logically flaw in a Ampere law and give him the complete set of equation for the electric and magnetic field. What is the flaw with Ampere law? Here I am taking a capacitor problems. We have draw three path, 1, 2, 3. Path 1 around the wire leading into the positive plate, and path 2 around the wire leading out of negative plate, and path 3 around the gap between the two plates. Here I am writing the Ampere law for three path. You can see here I the intercept this area. We can write the line integration of the magnetic field like that, and here also, but here there are no current it intercept this loop, so that the current is zero. When we write out the Ampere law this way, the discontinuity in the current at the capacitor plate looks a bit of more disturbing. It means that no, we simply cannot have such a discontinuity in a magnetic field, and there must be something wrong with Ampere law. This was the problem recognized by the Maxwell. Here I am showing the recognized of the fault in Ampere law. In a next slide, we will give the solution of this fault. In this slide, we will discuss the Maxwell solution. Here I am considering the same problem. Here this plate have a positive charge, here this plate have a negative charge. Here they are changing in an electric field. We can measure the electric flux in this closed loop. How can measure? We can calculate the surface charge on the plate is equal to QI by A. And also we can calculate the electric field is sigma upon epsilon naught. We can write the charge is equal to the epsilon naught electric field and area of the plate. The current following into the plate of the capacitor is related to the charge, and that was accumulated by, we can write the current dQi by dt. This current will equal to the this one. We can say that the when the electric flux is changes, the current will be changes. This current is known as the displacement current. It means that there is no current through the path, but there is in a electric flux. So we can write the line integration of the magnetic field in this form between the capacitor. The Maxwell proposed that this equation played the same role inside the capacitor as the source term for this one, that mu naught I did outside in the wire. This current is known as the displacement current. Now we can write all the three path of the Ampere law like that. Path for the path 1 and 2 is equal to the mu naught I, where there have no electric flux outside the this one. And in the between the capacitor, we can write the Ampere law in the form of that one. That is the integral form of the Maxwell correction of a Ampere law. In the last slide, here I am showing the Ampere law with correction of Maxwell in the form of differential form. Again, summarized all the law in this table. Here is the integral form, differential form. Here is the electrostatics and magnetostatics. First law is known as Gauss law. Second law is known as the Faraday law. Third law is known as no name. And the last fourth law is known as Ampere's law with Maxwell correction.